In other news this morning, our next guest is one of the few women in Bachelor history to receive the final rose. But it still was not exactly a fairy tale ending for the Jackson, Tennessee native Sarah Stone Smith. She may have won the Bachelor, but the Nashville teacher did not end up marrying Travis Stork.
Now, more than 10 years after being on TV, Sarah is finally opening up for the first time about what really happened on her season of the show. Sarah, welcome to Live at Nine. So glad to have you here.
Yeah, it's glad to be here.
So what really happened on the show?
Oh, well, where to start? It was a great experience, and when I was approached to do the show, it was an opportunity that I felt I couldn't turn down. It was in Paris, France, and who gets the opportunity to go to Paris, France and travel like that? You know, that doesn't happen every day.
So reality TV in general, we always are sort of skeptical that it's really real. What did you find behind the scenes? I mean, what do they play up that's not so
true? You know,
true?
It was hard for me to watch the show back because I took from the show so many great memories and time spent with the girls and great things and fun things we did and laughed about. And then when they'd play the show back, all the fun things seemed to get cut out. And you'd see a lot of eye rolling and drama and things that didn't really take place at the same time.
Cattiness kind of?
Cattiness that really wasn't there. They just kind of blow it up and make it into something a little more than it truly is.
That's what I've been wondering. You know, you watch shows like that, Sarah, and then you really wonder how cutthroat is it really behind the scenes?
Yeah.
Is it?
Not at all. We all got along great. We have great memories from the show. I had a great experience. And so for me, when girls ask me about the show, should I do it? What should I, you know, advice you can give me for doing a reality show? I always say, go for it. You know, it was a great experience, a lot of fun, but be cautious because one comment that you say, one action, one eye roll, and you become the villain, you become the bad girl, or the good girl.
Do you have any say-so in that whatsoever, or do you kind of sign away everything?
You pretty much sign away everything. You're kind of at their mercy.
So you are now the mother of three daughters.
Mother of three, yes.
Is it a little bit like, oh, we're going to compete for this man, sort of icky? In today's world.
Yes, it is. And, you know, at the time, it's just more about being on the show and having a fun experience. And I think now it's kind of getting portrayed more as a game show than it actually is finding true love.
Yeah.
So how does this also, Sarah, play into the now Me Too movement that we all hear about almost on a daily basis these days?
Well, I feel the bigger the show, the bigger the responsibility. And The Bachelor is probably, if not the biggest, reality show out there.
Yeah.
So I feel it's their responsibility to portray women in a positive light. Because when we watch reality shows, we take from that, and that affects our reality of how we treat not just women, but men as well.
Right. So you and Travis, he picked you. You got the rose in that romantic moment. But by the time the show aired, and you had that final scene, you were no longer together. Was there pressure? Did you feel
there was a lot of pressure to stay together? Yes. And he and I were great friends, and I really cherished the time we had after the show because we really needed one another. He was a great support system for me, and I hope that I was that for him. But after the show, we kind of started seeing how they were manipulating our conversations, and he would tell me something, and I'd say, I would never say that. He said, I didn't think you would, but so you start to see the manipulation that's going on. And what was so hurtful is that these are the producers and the executives that are doing the show are your friends. They become your family because when you go on these reality TV shows, you're taken away from your family, from your reality, and these people become your family.
One last thing very quickly here. Do you watch this current season of The Bachelor or, I guess, upcoming season of The Bachelorette?
It's hard to watch reality TV now after knowing the behind the scenes. I like to watch it at the end, when I can kind of pick out the winner and kind of get past all the games that they play.
Yeah, but just keep in mind what it is. It's sheer entertainment.
It's sheer entertainment. Yes.
Thank you so much for sharing your story. We all like to peek behind the scenes.
Yeah, we do. You've given us that glimpse inside.
And we should say she has found true love in Jackson, Tennessee.
Yeah, you got it. All right.